Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
What is your full name?
My full name is Manisha Saini.
How may I address you?
I always go by Manisha.
All right, Manisha, can I see your ID?
Yes, ma'am, here it is.
Where are you from?
I hail from Royal City, Patiala, which is primarily known for its religious shrines, majestic palaces and glorious gardens. My city comprises much more than what I am describing.
Do you work or study?
Well, I graduated a year ago and from that onwards I have been working for a multinational company as a mobile application developer.
What kind of technology do you use at work?
Being indulged in the field of computer science, all the devices that I use at my workplace are technological. These are internet-enabled mobile phones, laptops and computers.
Where was your first school located?
My first school was located in the heart of the city and I would say that it was the best place ever, as being surrounded by highly serene ambience and calm premises.
Did you walk to school?
No, actually my school was approximate 3 to 4 kilometers away from my home, so I used to travel over there by my school bus.
Did you enjoy your travel?
Yes, I really relished my travel.
Do you have many wild animals in your country?
Yes, we do have diverse kind of wild animal species can easily be observed in my country. These includes the Bengal tiger, leopards, rhinos and lions.
Where do people go to see them?
People mainly visit wildlife sanctuaries, zoos and national biological parks in order to get an exposure of such wonderful creatures.
What countries take very good care of their wildlife?
It's an uphill task to enumerate all those, as These are the ones which do have insight that conservation of wildlife plays an important role in the ecosystem.
All right, this is the end of part one. Now in part two, I will give you your cue card. You will have 1 minute to prepare on it and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. Fine?
Yes.
Here is your cue card and this is your paper and pencil.
May I start, ma'am?
Yes.
Disappointment is a kind of feel which comes when one is not gratified with what he or she is getting. One such moment I'm recalling this time was when we, the student of 5, were allocated with a single task. Through this all, I got an amazing opportunity to become a team leader, and I resolved to deliver the task to all the candidates as per their preference and according to their own strength. 2 were allocated with the job of database front-end and back-end development. Another 2 was provided with the task of database development. I involved myself in the process of coding, and the weakest part of our team was the student Divyam, to whom I merely provided the job of presentation. But when I saw that he was procrastinating in preparing the contents for it, I felt highly disheartening. Then I resolved that I would do that all by myself and give content to him. A team is all about cooperation, coordination and decisiveness. So that day I learned that we can't change others, but what we can do is to change ourselves.
All right, in this part 3, I will ask you a few questions related to this topic. Other than this incident, have you ever felt disappointed?
No, I'm not recalling any such moment that I felt that when I was feeling disheartening.
What do you think of people who achieve success independently?
As per my perspective, such people are highly ambitious, diligent and optimistic. They believe in their own power and strength. They know that how they have to accomplish their goal, and this is the reason that they succeed independently.
When do you think people quit their efforts while trying to achieve a goal?
If a person is getting merely failures in spite of making diligent efforts, then this thing would definitely restrict a person from keep trying.
So what do you think? A person should keep trying or give up?
No, I think that one should definitely make efforts and keep trying. This thing would surely make a person to succeed one day.
All right, this is the end of your speaking test. Well done. You spoke very well. Well tried. But try to speak more in part 3. Try to give examples in part 3. Your score for this kind of speaking is 8 band.
Thank you, ma'am.